Get it on. All right. Well, so let's get it on with Relationship Coach Sadie Shaw. Tonight's topic is it's over, but we still have children together. How does that mesh? How do we do that? What is the proper etiquette for dealing with someone when you have a child with them to make it best for yourself, best for the child, and last but not least, best for your new relationship? Okay, so I think there's probably two of us in the studio who has children, right? Yeah. And I think you dated someone with children before, right?
Of course I have. It's okay, 2012. So almost everybody has children. I mean, me that don't have kids, I'm like, what's wrong?
Why? Because everybody gets it on?
Everybody gets it on. Yes. Absolutely.
You okay over there, JP?
I'm fine.
Bro. Okay. All right. So that's what we're going to talk about tonight. What is the proper etiquette for a relationship when it's over? How to deal with your ex who you have a child with, who's basically going to be in your life forever. Caller that we have on the line. Do you hear the topic of tonight's call? We have two callers on the line. Okay. Callers that we have on the line. Do you hear tonight's topic?
Yes.
Okay. So we're referring to ex-husband, ex-wife, baby mama.
Baby daddy.
Your baby daddy. We're talking about him tonight. Okay, so what do you think? When one of the callers is like, answer this question, it's one of the hardest things after a couple breaks up, but they still have to talk to each other and deal with each other and be cordial with each other and work with each other when they have children. Someone like to answer that question?
It's not easy.
Yes.
Okay, can you please state your name? Because if you don't state your name, I have to refer to you as Putin Tang. And you don't sound like a Putin Tang to me.
I'm Ishtar.
Hi, Ishtar.
Hi.
And I'm sorry, Ishtar. There's another caller on. Caller, would you like to state your name?
Okay, we're going to hear from Ishtar. Go ahead, Ishtar.
One of the things that that children are used for is for either spouse to use them as far as being with the other spouse. Mm. They'll say, well, I have to do this for my child, I have to do that for my child. And a lot of times it's really not for the child, it's for themselves to be around the spouse.
Okay. So the first thing we're going to address tonight is sometimes when people break up, it's not always a mutual breakup, meaning one person may still want the relationship, right, Ishtar? And they'll take in turn and try to use the child to be around that person that they were in a relationship with as much as possible. In turn, they're trying to pretend that it's about the child, but it's really about them. So let's address that tonight and why that's not good for the child, why it's not good for the relationship that the parents have to now have as parents as opposed to lovers, you know, married couple, whatever it may be. Okay, one of the things we can talk about is, number one, people who use the child. Oh, I swear I could take this off. Okay, so people who use the child, right, when relationship's over. All right. So now, why is that not good? Let me tell you why that's not good. Because, one, sometimes the person might be like, you know what, I'm going to come over and put the child to bed. Right? You ever hear that? Oh, I got to go put my daughter to sleep. She can't go to sleep without me. You ever hear that stuff? It's over. Right? But you going over your ex's house, right, to put your daughter to bed. Or, let's put it on a flip. The kids are with the ex baby daddy or her husband for the weekend. And the mother talking about, oh, he just called. My son won't go to sleep. I got to go there and put him to bed. Mm-hmm. Okay, listen.
It's over.
Who else has the adapt to it being over?
The children.
Oh, yeah, them too, right? Mm-hmm. So, when the kids go over daddy's house, whose time is it?
Daddy's time.
When the kids with mommy? Whose time is it? It's mommy's time. So who should be dealing with the fact that the child won't go to bed?
That parent that the child is with.
Because what happens when you keep going over there to put the child to sleep?
The child going to think y'all still together.
And the child's going to what? Keep expecting that. So how is the child moving on?
No, the child will never adjust.
Now, so that one parent that's going over to him, I'm going to put my daughter to bed. Well, I got to go because he called my son won't sleep without me. I got to go over there. It's 7:30 at night. Okay. What happens when you're using that child just to be around that person that's over with? What happens when you finally move on? What happens when you don't do that anymore? When you're like, I can't come over because mommy going out. You're finally moved on. Now the child's like, wait a minute, but you used to come over before? What happens when the man is getting the child more often than not or won't get the child at all because he's trying to keep the woman from going out? Mm-hmm. Right? When he's like, you know what? I can't get him this weekend. And you're like, well, come on. I mean, okay, now in turn, one of the things that's happening is anytime, just like with your employees, you want them to go home and have family time and get rejuvenated and come back so they can what?
Work.
Right, and you want them to be what? Their top, tip-top performance, right? That's why they have lunch hours and all that stuff. So what happens when the man doesn't pick his kids up and the mother's just stressed out, doesn't have a break? What happens? Is she at her tip-top performance? Are the kids getting the best of her?
No.
Okay, so what happens to guys who use the child when the relationship's over? Or women? Sometimes the men are raising the kids and the women do the same thing. No, those are your kids. I'm not going to get them. I'm hoping that he in turn can't get out and meet someone else. Okay, women do it too. Let's talk about people. We're not going to put this on one sex. People do these type of things. Okay, but what happens when they want to keep coming over? Oh, don't worry about it. I'm going to come over and I'll give him his bath at night when he's with you. And then you going over there, you giving him his bath, only to still be around that person that you're no longer in a relationship with. Mm-hmm. It's not about that child. So what happens when you finally get over it? Now the child's going through another withdrawal. Because they got used to you being a certain way, which wasn't really about them. It was about the relationship to begin with. So now when you finally move on to a relationship, here goes the child going through something else. Because you were just using the child to begin with. Okay. So now that's one thing that we talked about. Thank you, Ishtar. That was a good point. Why it's not good to use children in relationships? Because it's delayed hurt. It's postponed hurt. When a relationship breaks up, the child goes through some kind of disrupt, you know, a disappointment, whatever you want to call it. It's natural. The best thing for the parents to do is be partners. Companies merge all day, every day. Companies buy out other companies. But the first thing the two heads of the companies do is get together and decide how they're going to make this transition as smooth as possible. Are there any emotions involved in that? Sometimes there could be. But what they decide to do, because one CEO may know that he's not going to have his job at the end of this merger acquisition. Okay, right? One CEO knows that, you know what, I may not be the CEO of this company at the end of the merger acquisition. So he, in turn, there's some emotional something going on inside of him. But what do? They get together and decide the best way to make sure that this transition is smooth for the company and successful. And that is the same thing that the parents have to do when they decide that they're not going to be together. What is the best way that we can make this transition as smooth and successful for our child? And holding on to the relationship is not good for the child, whether it's resentment, anger, or still carrying out that person and hoping that it could work. If you're going to still hold on and hope that it can work, you don't hold on to the child. Or you don't hold on through the child. Okay? All right. So now, we talked about that. Let's talk about angry parents. Okay? Who break up. All right? And talk about one parent to the child. Meaning they're like, okay, you know what? Yeah, your mother ain't no good.
That's the worst.
Your mother's no good.
I dealt with that personally.
This is, you know what? You're growing up in a broken home because of your mother. Or how about, you look just like your father when you make that face. I can't stand that face. You act just like him, too. I hope you don't grow up to be like him. That's what about terrible. Stuff like that?
Terrible.
So what is that doing?
It's causing a wedge between the child and that particular parent that they're talking about.
Right, so it's like resentment to the child, right?
Right, but
for the broken relationship. Yeah, but I'm sorry.
And later on in life, that child could end up having resentment for the parent that talked about the other parent.
Right. So that's another thing that's just improper etiquette for parents who we'll call them partnered parents, okay? So once the relationship's over, you are now partnered parents. You're partners in parenting your child together. Whether you were married, whether you're baby mama, baby father, you're now partnered parents. Parents were partners, okay? So basically, the resentment and talking about the other parent is out of the question. You're really making yourself look bad. And if the child doesn't recognize it now, when the child's old enough to know, they're going to be like, wow, mom used to do that, or wow, dad used to do that. It's not a good look. It's not a good look, number one, for you later, because that child's going to grow up. And even if you don't want to be in your child's life when they're younger, or you don't care, or whatever it is, you're into your own thing, the older you get, you start to realize how important family is. At some point, you start to realize how important family
Absolutely.
Is. And when you do start to realize that, you may now want to go back and look at things and not understand why your child or your children feel the way that they do. But it's because of some of the things that you may have said or some of the things you may have done. And you may think that it's, oh, well, I'm just telling them the truth, you know. They'll find that out.
There's a time and place for everything.
But guess what? If the mother or father is that awful, they're going to see it for themselves.
Right.
They're going to see it for themselves. You don't have to tell them. They're going to see it for themselves. Okay? So, resentment to the child for the broken relationship. Let's talk about baby mamas and baby daddies who get it in. Okay? And have other people in relationships they're with. What does the child see now? Okay? So, we got three. Right? We got relationships over. Baby mama and baby daddy still see each other, if you know what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Okay? But they're both in relationships with somebody else. So the child now sees mom is dating Frank, dad has Melissa. But then when mom drops me off, mom and dad still.
Right.
But then they go home, Melissa.
Right.
To Frank. Mm-hmm. What are you teaching the child?
That's a good one. That's a real good one.
What are you talking about? What? You never heard?
Well, no, I have. I say it's a good one.
That's why some people won't date people who have children, because sometimes the baby mom and baby father still.
Absolutely. Right. You know what?
Yep.
I'm with you on that.
That's why some people just, and it's not the kids. People immediately think, oh, I don't date people with kids. It's not the kids. It's either sometimes the drama that comes with dating people with children, or sometimes it's the fact that they haven't let go all the way.
Right.
Right? So, I'm sorry, did you want to say something?
No, I'm just saying I'm in a situation like that right now. Yeah.
I hope not with it.
No, I ain't saying that, but they haven't. I don't think they totally let go. Mm-hmm. You know, they got to move past it, because they feel as though they still got to add this parent in every aspect of what they do. And it don't have to be in every aspect. And this was a situation that I said, the parent, the father actually said, he didn't want to have nothing to do with the child, and said it in front of the child and her. Mm-hmm. And so we both agreed, because we're together, okay, indebted. If he said that to the child in front of the child, he hurt the child real bad by saying that, then it's a wrap. Now, a couple months later, the child's like, oh, I want to see my other brothers, whatever. And you're contacting the father again. You know, you're giving him a free pass again, you know, to be a part of this child's life after he said to this child, I don't want to be bothered with this child anymore.
Right.
So I think there's a problem with that.
Okay. Well, sometimes person feels like, okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to come back to baby mamas and baby daddies who still hang in there with each other when they're not supposed to. But let's answer your question now while it's at hand. But I just want to put that there so someone can remember when we come back. Basically, Ishtar had said it best. When she first signed in, how people use the child as an excuse. And it definitely sounds like that's what this gentleman is doing with the woman you're talking about. He's using the child to manipulate the relationship to try to get what it is that he wants from his partner parent. Okay? So oh, well, if you do X, Y, and Z, I won't see my son. Because, come on. What we all want as parents is want everything for our kids. And that includes their other parent, okay, whether it's the mother or the father. So we're going to, after you get over the hurt and resentment and you're ready to deal with him as a partner parent, you're willing to do whatever you need to do to keep that person around, because you realize your child loves them and wants them, right? So he's using that. Now, on the other hand, I can understand for her, she wants the father for her child. Even sometimes if she knows what it is he's doing, she still doesn't want him to grow up, because, you know, boys sometimes do this to their mothers. And sometimes children do this to their parents, period. They grow up and blame them for their parents not being around. So she may just be trying to avoid that. I want to make sure that I did everything possible to give him the opportunity to be in his son's life so that he doesn't grow up and be like, well, mom, you know, you can let him see me. Because we all know the father's going to lie, right? We know that. We know that the father's going to lie when the boy is, say, 18, 17, 19, 20, and say, you know what, I wasn't around because your mother started dating this guy back then who she may still be with or whatever, but he didn't want me around, so your mother didn't let me come around. She's making sure that she crosses all her I's. You know, wait, you cross a T. You cross all your T's and dot all your I's. That's what it sounds like trying to make sure she does to me. I don't think there's no pun. But at the same time, that's one thing we were going to talk about, too. How, you know, you love your children. You have to love your children and give them your all. But the fact of the matter is, they're going to grow up one day. And my son's going off to college in less than 6 months.
Wow.
And they're going to live their lives. Okay? So you can't necessarily badger your relationship over your ex, okay? It's also not healthy for you. And make yourself totally unhappy because of the situation with the ex over the child. The best you can give your child is a happy you. You can't give somebody what you don't have. If you're not happy, you can't make a child happy. So that's something else we're going to go to soon. Basically, what she needs to try to decide is that she's not going to let her ex ruined her relationship, because that is his ultimate goal. He doesn't seem like he cares what happened to his son in the crossfire, but his goal is to take his words and his actions as a gun and shoot to kill the relationship. And it's like she has two things she needs to worry about, where it sounds like she may just be focusing on one, which is the child, but she needs to realize that the child, he's not thinking about. The child is just caught in the crossfire as the shots are being fired. The shots are aimed at her relationship and her ever being happy. Because if anybody else comes along, it's going to be the same thing with that. So the shots are aimed at her happiness. And that's what she needs to kind of say, you know what? You're not going to kill my happiness. And that's that.
But let me ask you, because I've actually seen a lot of situations where there have been women who have kept their past baby daddy out of their children's lives. Yeah, they may have moved on to other relationships, but that might not necessarily be the case. It could just be because they just have so much animosity with the past relationship that they feel like the best way for them to keep their child from going through what they've gone through is by keeping that father out of that child's life. So what about like in those particular situations?
Well, if the child is physically, emotionally abusive, verbally abusive, then yes, you know, when you go to the court, you know, for child support or custody or whatever, the decision that the judge makes is not what you want, not what she wants, but what's in the best interest of the child. That's how they make decisions. So if the parent is physically abusing, emotionally abusing, verbally abusing the child, then 9 times out of 10, the judge will give the other parent full custody or have supervised visits. So this way the parent is less likely to do these things in front of the other child. So yes, when a parent feels like, you know what, it's actually in the best interest of my child to interact less with the other parent, to have less interaction with the other parent, then yes, that's a decision they have to make as the healthy, more sound in mind parent. So in that case, yes. And it definitely sounds like in this case, the child's being emotionally abused. That's emotional abuse. To say, I want you out of my life, I'm done with you, come back a few weeks later and say, oh, I'll be in your life now, and then as soon as you're mad at my mom again, get out of my life, that is emotional abuse. And what the mother needs to realize is it's actually better for the father not to be in a child's life than for the child to endure that type of abuse. That's abuse. And it can be damaging to the child in latter life. So you're right. Thanks for bringing that point up. It's actually better for the mother to make the decision to say, H with the father. You know what? You want to go? Go. And don't come back. And when you come back, if you come back, you're going to have to take me to court to see him because you're hurting him. And it's not better for him. And actually, the next time he leaves, she should go down to the court herself to protect herself and write a letter to the court saying he stepped out today and this is what he did. You know, because any form of abuse, you know, you're better, there's a saying, you're better have grown up with your grandma than with two unstable, gross, not loving, horrible parents.
You know, my father, well, sperm donor that he is. Oh, yeah, I called him that too. I talked about that. I called him that to his face. Like, we are not speaking. But when that's how he was with me. Like, I'm his firstborn. I'm the oldest out of seven, you know. And he does not socialize with me, but he still wants to contact my mom.
Right.
Like, and he could call, and I can answer the phone, and he'll know it's me. Like, he knows my voice. You know, he won't even acknowledge me. He'll just, hi, may I speak to such and such? I don't know it's him, just like he knows me. He won't say, hi, how are you doing? Is your mom home? You know, how you doing? And this and the other. He never, ever does that till this
because
day.
He doesn't want to address his own guilt.
Exactly. And then, you know, he's married, and his wife is always like, she's always like, well, you know, you should be the bigger person, and this, that, and the other. But it's like, I've been
she
there.
She tells you that?
Yes. Mm-hmm. And it's like, I've been there, done that. I'm over it at this point. My mom never badmouthed him, but my mom always said, like, because I was my mom's only child for 13 years. So I always wanted to go with my father because that's where all the kids were. You know, right. All his kids are like stair steps. They mm-hmm. back.
Right.
So I always, of course, just go over there, but he would call her and try to see her on a personal level, and she wasn't in there for it, so he wouldn't come pick me up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And but I think time I maybe was like between 11 and 13, I put it together for myself.
Right.
So like I never got a birthday call, no graduations, no anything. So I kind of put it together, but she never badmouthed him. But mm-hmm. till this day, he still will not acknowledge me.
Right.
Till this day.
There's a lot of women, men who go through that, you know, when they don't want any parts of the relationship anymore or even the intimate parts of the relationship. Then a lot of times people turn on the kids, and yeah. That's just the way it's not right. Yeah. And I hope that people who go through this don't personalize. Again, we talked before, you cannot personalize anyone's behavior. It's always whatever it is that they're going through that they do that to you. Your father and any other father out there in the world or any other mother or who else, it was whatever they were going through, they made the decision not to be in your life. It's not you.
Because when you're that young and something like that happens, you kind of start to feel like, well, what did I do? You know, why won't he see me? Why isn't he talking to me? But, you know, you have to get older and then you start realizing, putting it together. But when I was young and that was happening, like, I used to cry. It just messed up the whole world. Like, why? But it's like, He just ain't right in the head.
How many of us in here, and you'll see where I'm going with this in a minute, has actually gotten pulled over at those checkpoints where every so-called cardie,
oh, yeah.
They get you? Anybody, yeah. You ever had those? You had those, Norm?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let me tell you, it's the same thing when we came into this world, right? So when we came into this world, some of us got pulled over for the checkpoint to have a little bit harder in different areas than other people, okay? Some of us may have had parents and we grew up to struggle with drugs, okay? Some of us may have had didn't struggle with drugs, but we struggled with relationships, being constantly being in abusive relationships. Some of us may have not struggled with that, but we struggle with getting fired all the time. We can't seem to keep a job. Or some of us may have had a great mother and father, but they died in a car accident when we were really young. And we remember how wonderful they were. Some of us may have had an awesome grandmother who raised us. Some of us may have had one who really was there for us when we were younger. But then we grow up and we have a better child. We have a better life by what we provide for ourselves. Whatever it is, I said all that to say, don't personalize it. At those checkpoints that you go through, when you get pulled over, you're 1, 2, 3, 4, you're next. 1, 2, 3, 4, you're next. It's not you. It's who they chose at that time to be. They chose that time. You know, it's going to be Lady T. Mm-hmm. And then I go right by. 1, 2, 3, 4, it lands on JD. You understand what I'm saying? It's the same thing with your parents. Whatever they were going through that time, your life is all about timing. Think about some people you met years ago and the timing was just wrong. You know, it just... Sometimes you meet people and you guys get wonderful, very compatible if it's not the right time. And if you both don't want the same thing right there at that same time, it can't happen. Right. And that's the same thing with time. I mean, some people say, you know what? I was, my mother, you know, put me up for adoption, but then went on to have 10 more kids. But you know what? Maybe when she got pregnant with you, she hadn't developed into the person that she was when she decided to have those 10 more kids. Don't ever personalize what someone else is going through, father, mother, grandmother, teacher. There's teachers out there that say things out here, Biggie and Tupac saying their songs. My teacher told me I'd never be this. A teacher told me. You have to never personalize what people are going through and what they try to sell into your life. Your biggest cheerleader is yourself. All right? So let's go back. We're going to go back to the last thing we were talking about, which was baby mamas and baby daddies who still hang tight, if you know what I'm saying. But they're both in relationships. So what to teach the kids, okay? So I go over daddy's house, right? And daddy got a girlfriend named Melissa. Then I go over mommy's house and mommy got Frank. But then I see mommy and daddy hanging tight sometimes. What does that teach the children?
Yeah, they have an open idea of relationships. I think it really affects them on really recognizing what a stable situation is, you know. I know, like, as a young boy, I can't really speak from the mindset of a young girl, but I know if a young boy sees a lot of women coming in and out, then he's going to grow up thinking that he's supposed to have a lot of women coming in and out.
Right. So it all makes it harder for a boy to grow into a man and recognize the difference in what a man is and what is not. Mm-hmm. It also teaches him a different level of respect for women, right, to see his do those things and go back and forth, right? But it also teaches children promiscuity, right? When you say so, because I mean your first teacher is your parents. Mm-hmm. They teach you everything, right? You learn by what you hear them speak, right? A lot of times if the parents have an accent, the children come out speaking a language that's spoken in the home, or the same accent that's in the house, the children just have it, right?
But that's how a lot of people grow up if they are abusers. They get it at home.
Everything's learned. Racism, everything. I met someone who was very racist. Of course, a Caucasian male who was very racist, maybe about 10 years ago. And he just thought that African Americans were just the bottom of the barrel skunks, okay? And I just looked at him, you know what? Like I told you, don't personalize it. I didn't personalize it. I said, you know, someone taught him that. Mm-hmm. And that's what he was taught to believe. He really believes that. So, you know, I'll give you a pass because, unfortunately, when someone believes something that's not true, what does that make them? When you believe something that's not false, I mean, when you believe, not false, when you believe something that's false and has no truth to it, no validity, but you just, you take it on because that's what someone told you. It's a form of ignorance, isn't it?
Right.
Okay. So I looked at him. I said, oh, you know, just like you see a person in the bed that's sick. I said, oh, you poor thing. You're so ignorant. All right. You're going to be okay. And I just let him go, okay? But you know what? In time, what happened is he watched the way that I conducted myself. He's like, well, she's not stupid.
Right.
Right? She's not hood to the point that if someone says something she doesn't disagree with, she doesn't know how to handle the conversation on an intellectual level but just fight. Mm-hmm. It's like, well. And he came to me one day himself after 2 to 3 years of being around each other and said to me, oh, I think I was wrong.
What?
Yeah. He came to me and said, you know what? I think I was wrong. And actually started to let, he would never let any African Americans be around him. That's the best I can say. I can't say too much. But he never let any African Americans be around him. And after our interaction, he has tons of African Americans around him to stay. He never had an African American dinner at his table.
Wow.
Interaction, he had an African American dinner at his table. Again, I'm just telling you, don't personalize. And ladies, what I want you to do is I want you to try not to personalize your father.
Oh, no, I'm over it now because I'm grown at this point. So it's like,
are you sure you're over it? Because if you were over it, I feel like when he calls, you would say to him.
Well, now he's calling my mom's cell phone. Before, he was calling her house phone. Okay. So now he's calling her, so I don't answer my mom's cell phone.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? When he does call, he may say, oh, well, how's she doing? Mm-hmm. But my whole thing is, if you really want to know how I'm doing, you would call me.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not five anymore. You right. know what I'm saying? So
I think what you said, it was his wife that was telling you you're a bigger person. I think what she realizes that your father may have never grown up, and you're more adult now, woman now, than he ever will and was a man, and that she could talk to you, woman now, you would understand. But if she talked to him, he's enough to get it. And I think that's why she came to you, like, you know what, she's on my level.
Yeah, because when I go out there, you know, the last argument he has, every time we have an argument, he'll don't call my house. And it's like, whatever, I'll be over there when I come. Like, in my ear directly out the other, I'm not even comprehending what you're saying right now. But yeah, I go over there, like I have brothers and sisters that live in the house. You know, he'll be downstairs, I'll yell down and say hi. You know, whatever, he'll say hi back, and that be that. You know, but other than that, no. Okay.
I just, I got to give you a lot of credit, lady, because like you said, he'll call and he won't actually acknowledge you. Like me, I know me. You call my house. I don't know who you are. You call my house and you don't acknowledge me. You getting hung up on. That's, I'm serious. You call back when you get some sense. That's me. I mean, honestly, I've always been like that. All my family, like, you better say hello, ask me how I'm doing before you just start asking for questions about other folks. But it's interesting to me because I've also seen that happen a lot where another adult will come to the child and tell them that, you know what, your father or your mother doesn't seem to know how to handle this situation. This is what you should do. And I'm just curious how you feel about that, because a lot of times the responsibility is put on the child to be the bigger person in order to fix problems in relationship.
Well, okay, when you look at your insides, you want everything positive inside of there, you know? The way you feel is what you allow inside of you, you know? So sometimes we have to get over and let certain hurt go for us. It's not for them. It's for us. You got to empty out so you can be free. You know, your spirit, yourself, your being is like, you know, you want to flow. And when you got this weight on you, it's going to affect everything around. It's going to affect business. It's going to affect relationships. When you can stop and say, you know what, that person hurt me because they didn't know any better. They didn't know any better. And unfortunately, I have a better chance at life now of not being like that person. But when you hold on what they did to you, you hold on to a part of them. I call it like Dracula.
It's kind of like when you hold on to a grudge. It's affecting you more than it's affecting them.
True,
like,
very true.
Because they live in their life every day like there's not a problem.
Right.
And you sit in there like, oh my God. You know what I'm saying? And so you just have to let it go.
You just got to be like, no, you got to really understand that some people don't know no better. Some people just don't have good sense. They just don't. They don't have it. You can't do anything to give it to them. If you don't have good sense, you just don't have it. There's some people who are completely in love with people and go out and cheat on them.
And then when
they're ready, when it's time to be over, they're crying, talking about suicide and everything else. It's like, are you kidding me? Mm-hmm. You avoided this.
Right.
And then there's some people who are forgiven and go out and cheat on you again.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to Kobe.
And let me tell you something. Try to cut their wrists, slash their throat, take pills, everything. Mm-hmm. And you're like, wow, if it's that serious, let me give them another chance.
Right.
And you give them another chance, and they cheat on you again.
Mm-hmm.
That's called no darn good sense.
I feel you.
You don't want to be in a relationship with people who don't have no good sense. Because they can never give you anything positive.
But let me ask you, now, which person has no sense? The person that's constantly cheating or the person that's constantly taking them back?
The person who is cheating. The person who's taking them back, that's called love. It's forgiveness and love. Now, you keep taking them back years and years and years, like I'm not going to say a certain someone in the celebrity. After a while, that's not good sense.
A woman cheat on me, I'm never taking them back.
Okay.
One.
And that's your choice. You have that choice. I honestly, as a relationship coach, I realize that people fall short sometimes. They do. And that's why I told you before, I live by that saying, faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deceitful. Meaning there's people there that you walk in and they say, hey, Lady T. Oh, you look so beautiful today. Come here. And she's like, yeah, I'm going to take her
up.
Man. I wonder where her man at right now while she here. Lady T, you in here tomorrow? What time? How long are you going to be at the shop? I might come down. Really, she just read you.
No, she's trying to find out my schedule.
I witness that all the time.
Okay. Those are people who kiss you on your left and right cheek all day, and you never know they wronged you, but they're waiting for the right opportunity.
Absolutely.
Then you have people who hurt you deeply. They hurt you deeply because they're human. Mm-hmm. And then they're like, oh, man, how did I do that to JD? And then sometimes people can't say sorry because that means they have to accept that they hurt you. And they love you so much they can't accept that they hurt you. It's hard for them to accept that they hurt you because they know they love you. Mm-hmm. But they're human beings. Mm-hmm. Okay? And sometimes that's the scenario when a person cheats. Sometimes. That's it. But sometimes it's just people being selfish and they're not worthy of your love.
True.
It's sometimes it's one or the other. Now, some people say, you know what? Before I get out there and start over, I'd rather forgive you and give you a second chance because I love you. That's what love is about. Love is about forgiveness. Right? And some people are like, you know what? You hurt me so deep that I'm never giving you another opportunity to do that again.
Deuces.
There's no wrong and right.
Shout out to Island Girl in the chat.
Hey, Island Girl.
She said, I agree. And yes, so true to what you're saying.
Okay, great. Thank you, Island Girl. And good evening to you, too. So that's what I would say about the cheating thing. But it also, there's a lot of factors that plays in it. How long have you been together? Do you have children together? What do you have invested together? If you have children together, say you've been together 10 years, and, you know, the children are older or younger or whatever, then you might not want to just give up right away.
That's
I mean,
what
you got
10
years together. Come on. You know?
I know my friend, she has been with her now fiancé 10, 15 years, went through so much, you know, but they had investments together. It was more of a money thing. They had businesses together. They, you know, share real estate. So it's kind of like, yeah, we could break up, but we still got to go to this meeting tomorrow. So I'm still going to have to see you. So it's kind of like they never had an opportunity to completely break away from each other. They're engaged, you know. It worked out for them.
A lot of times when people just take their foot off the gas and go into ghost, they end right back to each other. Because what happens sometimes is when you just, you know, when you're forcing anything, you strip it.
Yeah.
So you don't force nothing. When it starts getting hard, just,
I'm going to fall back.
Spend more time at the gym. Spend more time at work. Don't be disrespectful to each other. Sometimes there's some marriages where people step out, both of them. They have relationships outside of the marriage, both of them. Mm-hmm. Same time. Nobody asks the other one questions because I don't like you right now.
Right.
But I don't like you either. Okay.
The feeling's mutual.
And then it ends for one of them. And it forms an appreciation for what you have at home. Mm-hmm. When you go through that whole process with that person on the outside. And eventually it ends for the other one too.
I can't do that, man.
Eventually it ends for the other one too. Then what happens? They come back together and the relationship goes to a whole nother height. Mm-hmm. That if they would broke up, you'll never see. People who keep breaking up and starting over will never see that.
Because I think that with my friend and her fiance, they have been through so much that it's like they're unbreakable at this point. You know what I'm saying? So even if something was to happen, it's like, well, what you did last year was worse than that. So I think they're at that point. You know what I'm saying? Well, what you did in 97, that was crazy. So I guess I could just let this one slide. Just don't let it happen again. I think that's where they are. And they have a understanding. You know what I'm saying? And it works for them.
There are some cases where you do need to break up, move on. Even if a person didn't cheat. Mm-hmm. You know, but those are factors that we can't go too much into detail tonight. But if you have basically that 60-40 going on and somebody cheats, then you might want to think about forgiving them.
Okay.
All right. So now let's go on to what is good etiquette. How should you? We talked about what you shouldn't do. Let's talk about what you should do when you have kids together. Let's talk about holidays. Holidays, ring, ting, tingling, do. Come on,
jingle
it's
bell,
lovely weather.
Bell.
Sleigh ride together. And the kids. No, I'm just joking. But let's talk about holidays. So what happens if you're dating someone, right? And they're like, listen, I know you want to spend Christmas together, but I want you, Lady T, my lady, to come by the house Christmas morning with me. I want to go by the house to my ex's house, and I want to be there with my kids, open their presents.
Whoa.
Wow.
Whoa.
This is a new relationship, right?
How long am I?
Like that? God darn.
How long? Because he's been there. I haven't. So
no,
I think we both should answer this.
He's asking you to come with him. You're going with
how
him.
Long am
okay,
I with
you're
this
going
person?
With her. She's like, listen. She's like, listen, babe. My ex-husband is coming over Christmas morning. He want to see the kids open the presents. Now they have a choice. Either the kids go over there and he gets to see the kids open the presents and she don't. Or the kids go over there and they get to. But now the kids are used to mom and dad being there together Christmas morning. It's the holidays. These are special occasions. Right? But you're there. Both of you are there. They're not going to slip off with you right there.
Go ahead.
Look, Jerome, take the kids over your house and open up them damn presents. because
that means he won't be attending.
Me and your ex is going to be opening up our presents with the kids after you finish and you bring the kids back to the house. It's not going to be no all blended family situation where you seen the ex and we are together. No, it's just not going down.
Ho, ho,
like
ho.
No, it's not going down like that because at the end of the day, still, you're confusing the kids.
Confusing the kids?
Okay. You're confusing
but don't
kids.
You realize once you break up and get with somebody with kids, that's what the families are supposed to blend.
Okay, listen. That reality is every situation and individual situation is different. So if somebody breaks up and they're no longer
well, if they have a very ignorant ex-husband who will cause problems, then you
absolutely.
Don't want to go.
Absolutely.
But let's speak in general first, then we'll go right to directly.
All right,
okay?
So
okay, but in general, you got a reasonable ex-husband. Maybe his girlfriend's going to be there too. You're with the new that's your new woman now, and they want to be together with their kids.
I want to teach my children that sometimes in life things just don't work out. You know what I'm saying? And I want to teach my children about change. And see, this is the problem. I don't think a lot of parents teach their children about change. Things change.
Things change, but
you got to teach them acceptance.
But I thought you guys all agreed on the partner parents earlier. You didn't agree with the partner parents?
No.
Okay. Before we go to your question, I just need to address something with you. What you sat here and said was all about you. But Christmas is for the kids. Stingy.
Christmas is for the kids. Why can't the kids open up their gifts?
Like, y'all go with Raymond.
Listen. Open their gifts with
Get
Jerome.
Get your butt over there with Raymond. Jerome.
Their gifts with Jerome. And then, after you open your gifts with Rome, then you coming back home with me and your mom, and we're going to open up our gifts together. At the end of the day, see, I'm a realist. I don't like Rome. Rome is always trying to cause problems.
Why don't you like? Okay, but what if Rome wasn't? Like we said, we're generally speaking, everything's okay.
All right,
it's okay. Now, listen, if we thought you and Rome was going to throw down, we wouldn't have y'all in the same room. We don't want no, we like snowballs. We don't like Christmas punches.
Rome, they're your kids. I understand that. I got to bond with your kids, too. Do your thing with your kids. When I see the kids, it's a whole different flag. I'm just keeping it 100. I'm keeping it real. I'm saying what most men really want to say. It's like, come on. I'm not really trying to bond.
We're gonna make her suffocate.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm going to say something. After.
Thank you. In a way, mm-hmm. I get what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
At some point, the kids need to know, hey, mommy and daddy are no longer together.
Absolutely.
There's a possibility that this is how Christmas and Thanksgiving or whatever is going to be. You're going to be with mommy or daddy, not the same. That's why I asked you, how long is this new relationship going on? Because also, at some point, there are going to be the joint holidays. You know what I'm saying? And
there's going to be weddings that you guys all have
right,
to go through.
At some point, there's going to be
graduations.
There's
going to be a lot of stuff. So it's like when you get ready to date somebody with kids, these are the things you need to be thinking about.
You can't
expect these kids to always have their parents separate because it benefits you.
I'm saying, like, if it's like first year, mm-hmm. okay. If it's the first year, it's new to the kids, it's new to the mommy, daddy.
Then I had to get them used to it the first year just for it not to happen next year.
No.
What I'm saying is, let's say they broke up in January. You know what I'm saying? So now we spent this whole year getting the kids used to daddy's over here, mommy's over there. Kids have met mommy and daddy's significant others. You know what I'm saying? I think I agree with Norm on that part. We should not spend the holidays as one big joint family with mommy's new boyfriend and daddy's new girlfriend. No, we should not. It should be, hey, you're here in the morning, you're there in the afternoon, or you're there this night, and whatever. As time goes on, if the new relationships are going to work out, you know what I'm saying? Then yes, I don't see a problem in doing the joint holidays because at some point they're going to have to get used to that.
That's what blended families are all about.
And I understand.
And that's the difference.
Let me give you a scenario.
Now, most likely, if the relationship is new, I want to address what she said. Hold on one second. If the relationship is new, you probably won't be together for the holiday. He or she will probably be over there and you won't know about it. But now, once you're in a relationship together, they want to keep you in the loop. So they want to say, you know what, This is what we've been doing. You can't expect them to change it because you came along.
If I'm with somebody in a year, oh, I'm gonna know what he's doing on.
Let me go on experience.
Wait, can I just,
I'm talking about a few months.
This going off of what both of you said, because I definitely agree with both of you. I think this has a lot to do with time of how long these people have been together.
Right.
Also, how old are these children as well? Because that's a fact as well. You know, because the thing is, you remember, you could have two couples that's fine. Like, yeah, okay, I know about your situation, you know about mine, we're good. But if the kids are still not good, then when you get together, they could be the problem. Because, you know, kids will go and tell exactly, give information just to specifically cause issues. So I think this has a lot to do with time and how comfortable everybody is with this situation.
Okay, generally speaking, if the two are over each other, but this is what they have been doing, okay? It is healthy.
So they're
over each other. It's healthy for the parents to get along. It's healthy for the new stepfather to get along with the new step. It's healthy. It's going to go down one way or other one day, whether it's the wedding, the prom, the graduation, the sweet 16. It's going to go down. You guys are going to all have to get along. That's healthy.
Sadie, I agree with you. Now, let me tell you the scenario that I experienced. So I'm a product of all this we're talking about. So now, my significant other's daughter, her grandmother was having a birthday party. Her grandmother was having a birthday party. So, you know, my significant other said, Norm, I want you to attend the birthday party because my daughter's grandmother means a lot to her, and she is cool. We're still cool, you know, after the fact. I want you to attend this party. So I was like, oh, wow, okay. All right, so I said, okay, cool, you know, because I like the daughter. Me and the daughter got a bond, you know what I'm saying? I leave the house, you know, daughter's like, love you, Norm. I'm like, I love you too, mama, you know, blah, blah, blah. We good. So I was like, I attended, you know, got put on my, you know, Cleaned up real nice.
Okay.
Yeah. So came to the function, to the event. I met father for the first time, whatever. And I met the grandmother and all of that. Now, this is just from...
So you met the ex?
Yeah, I met the ex.
Jerome?
Yeah, I met Jerome.
How was old Rome?
Rome was cool.
Everything. Jerome in the
and
house.
We had a good time. So then after the function... I get a call the next day, right, from my girl, and
what Jerome done say?
No, the family. Rome's mom was like, "Oh, he's nice. He's a nice guy. He's handsome. He's cool. He's laid back. Blah 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 blah. Whatever, whatever." But he's like, "Oh, he's cool. You know, blah 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 blah." And so I was like, "Really? The mom said this?" And he's like, yeah, and the sister and the aunt and blah, 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 blah. It was like, he was real cool. He was nice. He was a gentleman, blah, blah, blah. So I was like, okay, cool. So I embraced it at the end of the day. So that's one situation. So my significant other has two kids. And so there's another baby's daddy that's not on that same level.
Okay. Okay.
So that's why there's problems. So
okay, so I can understand. I won't be involved with that. Let me tell you something. There is a scenario that I know of with a client that the ex-wife didn't want to do any of these things that we said were healthy till there was a new girlfriend. That's a problem. Again, the key word that I said is if they had been doing these things before you came along. If they want to start to do them now that you're in a relationship, again, that's shots fired at the new relationship. It's shots fired at the new relationship to kind of try to kill it and cause problems. These are things that I say you should support to continue to help and continue if they were already going on. Jump in the flow. I'm in. What's up? Let's do Christmas morning. Put on your finest.
Okay, Island Girl, what's that LOL about? You need to call in. It's 4-6.
233-1302.
Again, calling at
646-233-1302.
All right.
Let's get it on with Relationship Coach Sasha.
All right. So we got about 8 minutes left. So let's wrap up. Ishtar, is there anything you would like to add? I'm sure our listeners would love to hear from you before we start to wrap the show up.
Anything to add?
Basically, for our listeners out there who want to know about proper conduct for dealing with someone who has a child with someone else, or they may be the person in the situation themselves. I have a child with someone, but it's over.
Mm-hmm. What I would like to say is that, you know, there used to be a place for children, but now it seems like the children run the parents.
You better say that.
So, excuse me?
Yes. I'm agreeing. You better say that again.
Yeah, I'm agreeing with you. I am agreeing with you.
And even like when there's two parents together, like the man was saying that sometimes the children try to come between the two people trying to get together. So even when two people come together, like you take your two fingers and you put them fingers together, they have to keep their finger like that. Guess what? They don't let her child come between them, and they don't let his child come between them. They have to set their standards, just like in any commitment. And them being together is a part of a commitment. So when they set their standards, they get their children together, look on a holiday, we're going to do that. And whatever they say they're going to do, the growing ups, not the children. And that's what they should do.
Okay. So, again, as I had said earlier, children are going to go off to college one day and be gone. So you don't let your children come between you. However, if the parents have been divorced now for 2-3 years and they get together every Christmas morning, then that's what the kids have been used to through breakup. They've already been through one disaster. You don't want to take them through another.
And I think that's good for the kids.
You do have a responsibility to your children at the end of the day to try to keep them emotionally stable.
Coach Sadie, may I say something else?
Sure, go ahead.
Because in the end, rather than two married parents or two people coming together, those children, just like you're saying, your son is going to college, those children are going to be gone, and who's going to be there together in the end?
Right. You will be there together at the end, but we also said that, you know, you want to make sure your kids are emotionally satisfied, because one day you're going to grow up and realize that you're getting old, and family's important, right? Family is important, and your children remember some of the things that you may have done that didn't take them into consideration. So as I had said, if this whole spending Christmas thing hadn't been started prior to you bringing a significant other into your life, then don't start it. But if you've been doing this 2 or 3 years, and then someone comes along, and you're going to stop doing what makes your kids happy because you have a new man or woman in your life, I don't believe they're going to forget that. And I know it's not proper and it's not healthy. Now, if your new significant other is, if you have someone in your life, and now your ex-wife is like, oh, you need to start coming over and putting the toys together for the kids and being here Christmas Eve into Christmas morning, that's starting trouble.
Island Girl in chat says she's not comfortable with anyone saying a child coming between them, but she only caught that part. But Ishtar did say that some people say they let the child come between them.
Sometimes, right. Let me say this. I'm gonna keep it
in a situation a child can, but like teenagers who don't approve of a relationship can try to come in between a relationship.
Children, young or teenagers, can be manipulative.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, they can.
Very.
Yes, they can. I agree.
I agree. And they know how to play on the weaknesses.
Yes, they do. Children can try to interrupt a relationship.
Absolutely.
They can, and
right. I've seen it. I witnessed it. Mm-hmm. You know, it is what it is. At the end of the day, this is when the parent has to become the parent again and not a friend.
Right.
Not a friend of the
and
child.
And let them know, I'm not going to let you do this. You stay in a child's place. As Ishtar had said, you got to keep a child in their place. But again, as a parent, you're responsible to your child. When you have a child, you take on a responsibility. And that's to them emotionally, verbally, or whatever. And because you met someone and you're in love, and your kids are used to doing X, Y, and Z with you and your ex every year. That's just like some people saying, oh, my ex can't come to the birthday party because I'm with someone now. No. Mm-hmm. That's improper and it's unhealthy. The child still wants their parent. They still love them just as much as they love you. You don't take the other parent away because you have someone new in your life.
That's right.
Now, if you have an ignorant other half, then I wouldn't have been time with them before that person came along, so nothing's changing.
I can honestly say, even though me and my sperm donor do not get along, however, when I was younger and I saw him, his wife, you know, everybody was in the same house. We spent the night. It was no problems. Everybody got along. His wife got up, cooked breakfast. And my mom act like they was the best of friends. I appreciated that.
Okay, let's address Island Girls. She says, okay, with that example, I understand. I just hate to see a woman put her child after love. And that's what I'm saying, Island Girl. Whatever your kids were used to, because a man or a woman comes into your life, you don't change it because they're there, right? But you also don't, if your child comes to you, and I've seen this with people, right? So this is what Ishtar's trying to say when she says, don't put, she's not saying don't put your kids first. What she's saying is, all right, little girl has her daddy, right? And she normally sleeps in her own bed. Now daddy has a new girlfriend. They're moved in together. Little girl want to sleep in the bed every night. Little girl want to sleep in the bed every night and cry and pee on herself when she can't. It's put your foot down because the child is trying. The only reason she wants to sleep in daddy's bed is what? Daddy's now in a relationship. So what Ishtar is saying is you put that child in a place and say, listen, you're going to get in your bed. And if you find yourself again, I'm going to.
Absolutely.
All right? Yeah. That's right. You understand what I'm saying? So that's what Ishtar means when she says you don't let the kids come in a relationship. But what I'm saying, okay, for a woman to, yes, be spending Christmas morning every Christmas for 3 years since the breakup with daddy and grandma all at one house, and now here she is dating Bob, oh, we can't come no more. The kids are like, but mommy, you know, we go. Well, y'all go by yourself. That is putting your new love before your kids. This is what they're used to, and Christmas is about the kids. We didn't say 4th of July. Mm-hmm. We said Christmas, and that's for the kids. So I agree with Island Girl. You don't go changing anything because you got a new woman or a new man in your life, but you also don't let your kids come in between your relationship. When they start acting out, as Ishtar said, as Norm has said, kids will try to interrupt and manipulate things, and sometimes it don't take them to be teenagers. Teenagers are more likely of this.
Right.
But I've seen 9-year-old little girls do it. Your father getting new girlfriends.
Right.
Okay? Sometimes boys do it. Dad, I don't like him. Why? What did he say? He told me to go to bed. He told you to go to bed? What time was it? Like 12 o'clock. And he told you to go to bed. Wait till I see him. And it's on.
Right.
Kids do that. And you got to be smart enough to be like, so what time was it? 12 o'clock. And sometimes you could tell the child, listen, you got a problem with my man, you come tell me. If I don't deal with it, then you go to your father. Right? But your child also don't need to be running out, telling everything, making a big problem to go on in your house.
Right. Let me tell you exactly. Because the situation I'm talking about, this particular child will call up the father. He'll be like, you know, this is going on, blah, 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 blah. Oh, come get me. Blah, 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 blah. And there's no real major problem that the mom can't handle. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it will cause a big
right.
issue or whatever. And then the mom is like all stressed out mm-hmm. because, she's like, why did he do that? You know?
Well, as we had said earlier, when the woman is trying to tell you she got to go over to the father's house to put the child to bed, and the father's telling you he got to go do something, he got to go put the child to bed, the child is with who? The mother. The child is with who? The father. So whatever parent they with, that's who deals with the situation. So if the boyfriend told the child to go to bed and it was midnight and he had a problem, and he should have went in there and said to his mother, Ma, Bob just told me to go to bed. And then the mother was like, boy, get your butt, you know? But he went to his father because he was what? Trying to start something. How did his mother never know about it? And that's what Norm and Ishtar are saying when kids come between things. But what we're saying is, you don't go changing what your kids, they've been through enough already with the separation. They're children. They don't have the same emotional system that you do. Okay? It's not strong enough, and it doesn't think and process the same way yours does. So here, they done been through enough already. Now, they've gotten, okay, mom and dad are separate, but we spend Christmas morning together. And now, you get a new person in your life. You simply put, listen, sometimes me and my ex, most of the holidays, we go by her mother's house. Okay, that's what I would like to do Christmas morning. Mm-hmm. I would love for you to come along, but Christmas morning, we're going to go by my ex house. We're usually there from about 9 to 11, and after that, we can go by your family's house and do whatever. If you don't like that, then you say it, you speak up. You don't have to be Absolutely. In that relationship, but you don't need to try to change it. If that's what they've been doing. Now, if you say to him, what do you usually do for Christmas? Oh, some Christmas, every other Christmas, we alternate. Some Christmases she has them, other Christmases I have them. Now all of a sudden he or she find out there's you, and oh, y'all need to come by my mother's house for this Christmas. Don't bring her. He need to step up and be like, well, I won't be there. Okay? Because when people take shots at your relationship, you recognize and handle it. But if it's been going on already previously, it's been the holidays, don't think because you come along, these kids' lives need to be turned upside down
right.
for your relationship.
thing I would like you to talk about as well is the fact that even in going into a relationship that you're talking about, okay, just knowing that it's a package deal when you go into a relationship with someone.
And again, that's why we said earlier, sometimes people don't want to date people with kids. It's not because of the kids. It's because of the baby mama, baby dama, the drama. All right, let's close down on the show. I hope you guys got something from tonight's show. We still have, it's over, but we still have children together. We're going to close with Jay-Z's So Ambitious. Whatever it is you want, work hard for it, whether it's your relationship. The ex could be trying to ruin it. Hold on. Ambition keeps it going. We'll get you there. All right. Till next week. Let's get it on Relationship Coach Sadie. New topic. Same time. 9 p.m. Eastern time. See you then.
Remember to stay tuned for the live and the